Think of Active Directory, or AD for short, as a directory service that stores, lists, and organizes information about elements in a Microsoft environment, such as devices, applications, users, and user account details, such as names, phone numbers, and passwords. Active Directory provides an authentication and authorization system to network resources. In simple terms, it allows users, once they're logged in, to find and access specific resources. Once the authentication is done, the user can then access the requested resource and data he is permitted to view or use. This is the authorization part. In other words, Active Directory helps control who can access which resources. The information stored in Active Directory is referred to as AD objects, and they are primarily categorized into three types. First, there are users, then there are resources, which represent hardware elements in the company, and finally, there are groups that are designed to create lists of users for assigning them rights or services. Let's explore how AD objects are organized within Active Directory. Here are some Active Directory objects: users, printers, computers, and some file sharing servers. It's important to know that users and resources are organized into groups and subgroups. Active Directory objects are contained within what we call domains, which are autonomous management entities. I'm representing a domain with a triangle. Inside this triangle, objects are classified into organizational units, or OUs, which are the small circles I'm drawing. OUs can represent various aspects of a company, such as departments, subsidiaries, IT resources, users, geographical areas, and more. Now let's delve into the concept of GPOs for group policy objects. GPOs are a collection of policy settings that enable the restriction of actions, like restricting access to certain resources or folders, disabling the use of specific executables, and more. Finally, GPOs can be applied across domains or OUs. This is why Active Directory is essential for system administrators. It's an administration and network management tool that simplifies the management of users and security policies. Now let's explain why we refer to it as an Active Directory tree when talking about the organization of Active Directory. An AD tree corresponds to a domain, along with all its subdomains, known as child domains. Moreover, this Active Directory tree is part of a more extensive structure referred to as a forest. This means that the forest encompasses both trees depicted in the drawing. To enable users from one domain to access resources in another, Active Directory employs a mechanism called trust relationships. These trust relationships grant permissions in a different domain from the one containing the user's domain. These trust relationships can take various forms, such as intra-forest, inter-forest, or inter-subdomain relationships between multiple forests. In essence, there are multiple types of trust relationships. This means that a user from one domain can have permissions in any domain within the forest. It also means that each domain is aware of the relationships it has with the other domains in the forest. I understand that this may still seem somewhat abstract, so let me illustrate all these AD tree concepts differently. In this example, the forest represents a company. This company has a presence in two countries, the United States and France. The AD forest is therefore composed of two trees, representing the two subsidiaries in these two countries, the US and France. Within these trees or countries, domains represent the cities where the company is established. Thus, within the US tree, we have the New York and Chicago domains. Furthermore, in the part of the company located within the Chicago domain, individuals are distributed among business units, such as marketing or human resources. Within these business unit OUs, you can see the individuals who are part of them, in fact, the AD objects like James for marketing and Sarah and Jessica for HR. For the final part of the video, let's explain the physical infrastructure of Active Directory. An AD architecture relies on domain controllers. It's important to know that an Active Directory architecture is based on multiple domain controllers that synchronize directory data between them, ensuring information consistency throughout the forest. Domain controllers handle communications between users and domains, including user login processes, authentication, and directory searches. Lastly, there's a specific type of domain controller known as read-only domain controllers, or RODCs. These are, as the name suggests, read-only domain controllers. RODCs are used in scenarios involving remote sites, allowing users to access network resources much faster while ensuring the security and integrity of Active Directory. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it has helped you better understand this topic, which can sometimes seem quite complex. If you enjoyed the video, don't hesitate to subscribe. See you soon.